I love when I get to sit in with people.
Yeah, but that's what I think is going to make the Crossroads thing so fun tonight. We have this commonality that serves as sort of the anchor.
I like not having to focus on singing, and I can actually look for places where I can shape the tone, the sounds, the feel.
We are absolutely the same when it comes down to the feeling that we have of flying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When the guitar goes over the song. It's like taking flight.
Yeah.
Baby, well, your pretty blue eyes, they were driving me crazy. And the tiny little doll that was so amazing, they were looking at me. I held up in the corner, folded, and you climbed inside and slid on over to the other side. I thought, my, oh, my.
Kissing on the porch swing. Oh, my sweet baby. Hello and welcome to Crossroads.
That's the pedal rig. Is that your pedal rig?
That's the pedal rig down there.
Someone else's. Yeah. So that thing just fires a little needle off into his butt.
Exactly.
That wakes him up and goes.
In 2001, our band was out touring with Brooks and Dunn, and then Room for Squares had just come out. Uh-huh. And Tim, the drummer in our band at the time, brought this record into the bus. Uh-huh. And we're all traveling on one bus, you know? And they're like, check this out. And we listened to No Such Thing and Why Georgia Why, and just loved it.
Thank you.
And played it constantly.
Thank you.
It was like the record of that tour. Every time we come off stage and we get in the bus, there'd be that record playing.
But it's just got bravado.
And it's spirit.
Just
it's
cocky.
Got spirit.
It's like a kid who shows up to the party and just starts dancing. You know what I mean? Yeah. And at this point in my life, I think I need to do that again. But I have to get over some stuff inside to be able to say, okay, now I'm ready to just go for it some more.
So dancing tonight on Crossroads.
Dancing. But two stars.
I
just
like
dancing.
That.
Two stars who can't dance, dancing.
You have to have the voice. You can't, you know, hello, I'm Johnny. I can't go like, hi, I'm John Mayer. It lacks a certain something. Can't get in front of Folsom Prison and be like, hi, I'm John, hello. First of all, I know you all didn't do it. I'm fine with that. Let me just play some music.
Did you ever get into playing guitar as an escape from something? Or?
I don't know if I think of it that way, you know. I just found something that I really loved and connected with. You know, I remember sitting in my room with my acoustic, and I went and got the sheet music to that song, You Make Me Feel Brand New. Mm-hmm. I don't know why, I guess it was on the radio at the time, and so I got the sheet music, or my parents bought it or something, and you open it up, and it's got the chords written above the words, you know, my love, and then it's got the minor,
right.
I'll never find the words.
With the guitar chart on top of the
exactly,
lyric.
Exactly, on top of the lyric.
And you could tell how difficult the song was by how many different charts were at the top, because they would introduce you to the number of chords.
Yeah.
And you would look at them sometime, there were 30 of them, you'd go, oh, this is tough.
Yeah, that's right. Or I'll just simplify it.
That's
know?
Right.
But I remember that feeling so well, like it was yesterday, of sitting there and playing that first chord. And to me, the feeling of that was the same as when you finally ride your bike with both feet on the pedals and you're going, and the whole thing has come together.
Not every day you get to get Keith Urban playing on your tune, so I'm going to enjoy the hell out of this if you don't mind.
understand is your rhythm is insane.
Oh, man. It's just hard to play that and sing it. That's the thing.
You have this incredibly melodic approach to soloing. It's almost like Clapton, but even more lyrical. And you found this thing, and you're like, I'm not trying to shred right here. I'm trying to sing something, which is really, really cool, and I'm going to steal it. Just wait.
Right then. I grew up listening to a lot of Mark Knopfler, and just loved his melodic sensibility, and his touch is matchless.
It is matchless.
The end of Romeo and Juliet or Tunnel of Love, actually, even, is just the most beautiful, they're a song unto themselves.
Yep.
The outros, yep. You know. And a lot of my records, I started doing these long, extended outros, which would make the song 6 minutes long or so, but on a record, what does it matter?
Doesn't matter. It's great live.
That was all inspired by those Mark Knopfler records.
That's sort of like When Summer Comes Around. That really slinky guitar playing. It's just the most tasteful playing. It's blown me away, man.
There was a song on the album before this one, Love, Pain, the Whole Crazy Thing, and the song was, I think I got it right. So it's kind of a song about finally finding the one.
Right.
And, you know, my wife said, well, why would you say, think I got it right this time? As a songwriter, I didn't consciously choose that word.
Right.
It's made me much more aware of saying exactly what I'm trying to say in a song now.
Yeah.
My dream is to get a phone call, not that I would wish ill on anybody, but for some reason, some band needs a guitar player and they're in a real bind.
Right.
Could I please, would I ever consider coming up?
Yeah.
And, you know.
I always remember Frampton went out with David Bowie on a tour.
The which tour?
I think it was the Glass Spiders tour, and I was always impressed by the fact that he did that just for one tour.
Isn't it amazing?
That's really cool.
Who would you want most to call you and say, we're in a bind right now, can you come out and play?
Well, probably your band, so if you get sick, whatever it is. The problem is the any band that I'd really love to play with, it's a conundrum because I like them because of the way they are.
Right.
I wouldn't, you know, what am I going to contribute?
Way to not enjoy the fantasy.
Yeah, right.
Me.
very strange. When you live for no one else but yourself, you can say all the things you want to say, and then it just gets sort of dark and lonely because you actually would like somebody to keep you in check and go, hey, what is that? Hey, come here. What are you saying?
Do you do good with that, with somebody to keep you in check?
Yeah, I do. I like representing somebody because if I don't, then I'll say whatever comes to mind because otherwise you just sort of spin off into the cosmos, you know? I would like to create the sound of a man at peace. I think that'd be a cool record for me.
Man at peace.
Man at peace,
as the follow-up to Battlestar.
Yeah.
I'm not afraid to die.
your biggest influences are who?
Stevie Ray Vaughan, Jimi Hendrix. You know, I was turned on to Stevie Ray Vaughan at a young age. And I think there was something about the fact that he had come out of the 80s. There was a certain fidelity to the recordings. Mm. Even if they're a little dated now in terms of the reverb or the drum sounds. For my ear growing up, that was like, okay, I get this. So I've always been in sort of a blues setting on the guitar. And at the same time, like learning the tunes of the day, which when I was coming up was like, you know, 80s hairband ballads. So I guess maybe that's like...
Do you still do any of those in your show?
No, but they're great at parties.
They'll Color Me Bad or
they're
something
great,
like that.
Great. I'm talking like Warrant. I'm talking Heaven.
Right? Heaven, is it too far away?
Wow. You know that song?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that's a great song.
Yeah. How many weddings have you played?
I have played one friend's wedding and sent a massive
perfect
invoice.
Sailor. Yeah.
Say hello to Steve Jordan playing the drums this evening.
Cause I got to have faith.